This segment brought to you by Bravo Company USA.
Hey, Larry Vickers here, Vickers Tactical. Today I've got a gun that needs no introduction. Colt M4A1 carbine, 5.56 NATO caliber. All right, let me take you through some of the details on it, and I'm gonna also point out a few things you might not be aware of. Roughly 6.5 pounds empty, 14.5-inch barrel, standard M16A2 flash suppressor up front, which also has a compensating feature because the very bottom of it is closed in versus the M16A1 flash suppressor. It actually works pretty good as a combination device. You see the barrel has a different configuration. This is for attaching an M203 grenade launcher to it. Move farther back, this has an F-marked gas block front sight assembly. The reason that had to come about is the height difference between the detachable carrying handle on a Picatinny rear upper receiver and the front sight. The early ones of the M4A1, you'd actually back out the front sight to the point that it would wobble. They made this one, it's a little bit higher, and then they've worked around that problem. Also notice the side mount sling loop. It used to be on the bottom. Now they made it where it's reversible left to right side, which was very much an improvement. Move back. Now you're looking at the double heat shield handguards. You can spot these because they're much bigger than the older CAR 15 handguards. Theory behind that was when you're hammering the gun, using it full auto like an M249 saw, which I don't agree with, the handguard gets very hot, of course. So what they did was they made it larger and they did a double heat shield so it protects your hands better. The problem is it traps heat as well. Not a fan of these. When I was in Delta, we always used the CAR 15 per se with the slimmer handguards and with very little full auto fire. So we really never needed the M4A1 double heat shield handguards when they came on board. Move farther back, the upper receiver has a flat top rail, Picatinny rail, and also detachable carrying handle. If you notice this one, I have an aim point mounted. What we used to do back in the day, myself and my friends like Ken Hackathorn, we'd take the Colt detachable carrying handle, machine off the carrying handle portion, mount a piece of Picatinny rail, and then take and mount an aim point to it. And we'd set it up to where we had bottom third iron sight. So we could look over the iron sight, see the dot, or if the dot's not on or the battery's died for whatever reason, we would drop our eye and look right through the iron sight. A real retro action to it. And I wanted to bring it out and show you guys this really cool aim point setup. This particular gun is M4A1 US property marked. And so it's fairly uncommon in the civilian market. Safe, semi, full auto. The predecessor was safe, semi, and burst. That went away with the M4A1 for good reason. Move farther back and we have the earlier polymer stock, which has long since been replaced. And now, as a matter of fact, these are collector's items. They're somewhat difficult to find, the Colt original configuration polymer stock. This particular one has a 4-position buttstock buffer tube. Later on, they had a 6-position. This is a 4-position, which is kind of the intermediate approach. Overall, outstanding gun, has served the United States well for a number of years. And you would have to say of the current production M16 style variants, the M4A1 would have to be the most famous. All right, we're fixing to light this thing up for you, Vickers Tactical style. We have some S&B ammo on board. Stay tuned.
Hey, Larry Vickers here. I hope you enjoyed this video. Click here to subscribe to the Vickers Tactical channel and take time out to check out some of our other favorite videos.